Hi everyone, it's me Indra. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video we are going to discuss about the some techniques of the differentiation. We have so many rules for the differentiation like coefficient rule, product rule, sum or difference rule. We will discuss about that in this lesson. Please watch this video till the end so that you will be very clear about the rules of the differentiation. After knowing the rules of the differentiations, we can calculate the derivative of any functions easily, directly. The first principle method or the definition method is very lengthy for the calculations of the differentiation of a function. So we can use the some rules for the calculations of the differentiation of a function directly. Here we will discuss about the rules. Without wasting any further time, let's get started. Here, the today's topic is rules or techniques. We can say the techniques of differentiation. Differentiation is the process of doing the derivative of a function. Here, we will discuss the rules of, rules of, this is of. Rules of the differentiation. The first rule is the coefficient rule. The coefficient rule is about the constant number, let's say a function. If a function y is equals to the f of x and a number k is a constant number. Let's take k as a constant number. Here we define f of x as a function and k is a constant. And if the derivative of the form like d over dx, this is the differentiation with respect to x. Of a function, let's say a function, some constant number times a function f of x. It is a new function. Constant number times f of x. The derivative of this whole the function, constant times the function, then that is same as we can take the constant term. Here the constant is k, this coefficient in the front. So this expression will be k times the derivative of the f of x, derivative of the function f of x with respect to x. Here will be the form. The derivative of the k times the f of x, where is the k is the constant number, is same as k times the derivative of that function. It is known as the coefficient rule. We can take the coefficient or the constant term in the front. And the second rule is sum or difference rule. Sum or difference rule. The second rule is sum or difference rule. Let's take two functions. Let's take the one function is f of x and the next function is g of x. Both are here the function of x, f of x and the g of x. And the derivative of their sum or difference, let's take the derivative with respect to the input variable x of the sum or difference. Let's take the sum f of x plus g of x first. This is the sum of that functions, those functions, two functions, f of x and the g of x. It is same as the sum of the derivative of the individual functions. That is, the sum of the derivative of both the functions is d over dx of the function f of x. It is the derivative of the first function f of x plus, here is the plus, so here is also plus, and the derivative of, let me write here, derivative of the second function g of x. Here the derivative of sum of the functions is same as the sum of derivative of that functions. Sum of derivative of that function. And this, the case is same for the difference also. If here is negative, here is minus, then here only change in the sign. Here will also minus. This is called as the sum or difference rule. The sum or difference, the derivative of sum or difference of any functions is equals to the sum or difference of the derivative of that functions. And the third rule is, let's talk about the third rule. Third rule is about the, this is the sum or difference rule. Third rule is general power rule. General power rule. Let's take a function. If a function y is equals to u raised to the power of n. Here a function y is defined is the u raised to the power of n, and the function u, and this function u is defined as the f of x. Here I am going to discuss about the general power rule. If a function y is equals to u raised to the power of n, and the u is defined is the function of x, f of x. And then at this situation, the derivative of y with respect to x, the derivative of y with respect to x is equals to n times u raised to the power, this u raised to the power n minus 1 decrement in the power, n times u raised to the power of n minus 1 times the derivative of the function u with respect to x. This is the general power rule. That is, the derivative of, let me write again, derivative of y with respect to x is just n times u raised to the power n minus 1 times the derivative of the function u with respect to x. This is the general power rule. Please memorize it. If the function y is equals to, in the form of f of x raised to the power some number n, if a function f of x raised to the power some number n, then its differentiation will be in the form, in this form. Let's take an example to illustrate the general power rule. Here's I have taken a function. A function is here given y is equals to here the function 3x square minus 5 whole cube. A function is given here y equals to 3x square minus 5 whole cube, and then we have to find out the derivative of this function y with respect to x. It is here to be calculated. Let's calculate the derivative of y with respect to x by using the general power rule. First of all let's suppose the u is this inside function. This is here 3x square minus 5. Here we just suppose a function u equals to 3x square minus 5, and then when we substitute this u, then our function, original function in terms of u, will be y equals to, this is supposed here as a u cube. If we substitute this term as a u, then our functions y equals to, in terms of u, equals to u cube. Then derivative of y with respect to x is just by using the power rule. It is just n times u raised to the power n minus 1 times derivative of u with respect to x. Here we just use, this is the power rule. This is called as the power rule of differentiation. And let's calculate it. At the value of the n is the power of u. Here the n is the power of the u. So here the power of the u is 3, and the u times the n minus 1. 3 minus 1 gives just 2, and the derivative of u with respect to x, here the u is defined as the 3x square minus 5. Let's calculate its derivative with respect to x. This is 3u square, and let's calculate the derivative. The derivative of the difference of the functions is always distributed, so we can write the derivative of this function 3x square minus derivative of this number 5. Here we just distribute, use the here the difference rule. This is the difference rule. We already discussed about the difference sum or difference rule. Here we just use the difference rule. Let's calculate here. 3 u square times, here inside this bracket we can use the coefficient rule. Here the coefficient is 3, so we can bring this 3 in the front. 3 derivative of x square with respect to x minus, and remember the very important point, the derivative of a constant function is always 0. The derivative of any number, any constant number, is always 0. Here we just use this is the coefficient rule. Let's calculate it. This is 3u square times, here we can use the general, we have the formula. Let me write the formula here. Derivative of x raised to the power n with respect to x is always n times x raised to the power n minus 1. We already discussed this formula. We already discussed the proof of this formula. Please memorize it. Here we are going to use the same concept here in this area. This is 3 times, the power is here, power is 2, times x raised to the power 2 minus 1 gives 1 minus 0. And this is for the simplified address. 3 times 2 gives 6, times 3 gives 18, x times the u square. U is here, suppose it is a 3x square minus 5, and it is here square. We finally obtain this result. This is the result of derivative of y with respect to x. Here we use so many rules to calculate the derivative of the function y with respect to x. Here we use power rule, difference rule, coefficient rule, all the rules. And here we also use this formula which we already studied about that. These are the rules. And let's talk about the product and the quotient rule also. Here the how many rules we study? 3 rules, and the 4th rule is product rule. The product rule is the about the product of the two functions. The derivative of the product of the functions, let's say the two functions f of x and g of x, their product is f of x times g of x. We are going to take the derivative with respect to x of this product function. This is same as, please remember this formula, the derivative of functions. We can take a functions, so let's say take a function f of x first. The derivative of the function f of x with respect to same x times the remaining function is g of x plus, we have to do the addition here in the product rule, plus here we take the derivative of the function f of x. Let's take the derivative of the remaining function g of x also. And let me write here, the derivative of g of x with respect to x times the remaining functions will be the f of x. This is the product rule of the functions. Let me write here d, derivative of the function f of x times g of x. It is same as the, let's take one function first, the g of x times the derivative of f of x with respect to x plus, we have to do the plus here. Please remember the point. Plus, here we take the derivative of f of x Now tan of g of x, derivative of g of x with respect to x times the f of x. This is the general, this is the product rule. Please remember this. This is the product rule. We will discuss the example of these rules in our next video. We will discuss about the quotient rule and the other rules for the calculations of the differentiation chain rule also. Please watch this video, watch this channel continuously. Please love this channel. This much for today.